Good morning friends. In previous lecture, we have studied about hydraulic power. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss about nuclear power. Before I start explaining about nuclear power plant, you should understand what do you mean by nuclear fission. The process which you are seeing on the screen is a nuclear fission. Nuclear power is generated by utilizing the energy in the nucleus of an atom. The energy stored in the atoms can be released if the atoms are split apart. The process of splitting the atoms is called nuclear fission, and this takes place in a specially designed nuclear reactor. Uranium, that is U-235, is widely used for nuclear fission. The nuclear atom, that is uranium-235, is used for nuclear fission process. In nuclear fission, a small particle called neutron hits the uranium atom and splits it, releasing a great amount of energy in the form of light and heat energy. And also neutrons are released due to the bombardment. As neutron hits the uranium atom, it is going to split it. As you can see that here, the splitting takes place, releasing a great amount of energy in the form of heat energy and light energy. Along with that, neutrons are released. 2 to 3 neutrons will be released due to bombardment. These neutrons go on bombard other uranium atoms. These neutrons will hit the other uranium atoms, and the process repeats over and over again, resulting in a chain reaction. These neutrons will hit the other uranium atoms, and the process repeats, and it is called as chain reaction. The chain reaction gives more amount of heat energy, which is used to boil water. The energy which is obtained from this is used to boil water to form superheated steam. Now we'll see how the nuclear power plant works. The sketch which you are seeing on the screen is a nuclear power plant. Now we'll see how the nuclear power plant works. Uranium is naturally radioactive element, abundantly found in most rocks, which is used as a fuel to nuclear reactor. You can see that this is the in the nuclear reactor we are going to place the uranium as a fuel. Here we'll be using uranium-235 as a fuel. In the nuclear fission, a small particle called neutron hits the uranium atom and splits it, releasing a great amount of heat energy in the reactor. Now the coolant, here you can see that the reactor, it is surrounded by the coolant. Usually the liquid metals like sodium or potassium is used as a coolant. The coolant in the reactor initially safeguards the fuel by absorbing the heat, that is absorbing the high temperature generated in the fission reaction. As the coolant absorbs the heat generated from the nuclear fission, the temperature of the coolant increases. Now the hot coolant then flows into the boiler. The steam generator is nothing but the boiler. In steam turbines, we have studied the turbine in which a steam is generated is called as boiler. Now the hot coolant then flows into the boiler and transfers the heat to water. Now the hot coolant will flow into the boiler and transfers its heat to the water. Here you can see that the boiler consists of water, thereby generating a superheated steam. The water absorbs the heat from the hot coolant and it gets converted into superheated steam. Now the superheated steam flows to the turbine at high pressure and propels it. Now the high pressure superheated steam flows through the pipe and hits the blades of the turbine. These blades are connected to the runner and the runner also starts rotating, and this runner is connected to the shaft. As a result of that, shaft also starts rotating, and this shaft is connected to the generator. The generator, which is coupled to the turbine, the generator is coupled to the turbine by means of a shaft. The generator, which is coupled to the turbine, rotates to generate electricity. As it starts rotating, it generates electricity. Now the exiting low pressure steam, the high pressure steam, as it hits blades, as it hits the blades, the pressure decreases but the temperature will remain same. Now the exiting low pressure steam passes through a condenser. As all of you know that condenser is nothing but a heat exchanger. Here there will be a transfer of heat from steam to the water and gets cooled. Now steam is cooled by circulating a cold water. The cold water is circulated to cool the steam from the cooling tower. The steam gets condensed to water. The steam changes from the steam gets condensed to water. Here steam will convert it into water as the cold water absorbs the heat from the steam. Now the water is then pumped back to the boiler by the pump and the cycle repeats. And in this nuclear reactor, you can see that control rods are there. These control rods are made up of cadmium or boron or hafnium. These are adjusted, that is, it can be moved up and down automatically to control the rate of nuclear chain reaction so as to increase or decrease the temperature. When you want to increase the temperature or when you want to decrease the temperature, by using this control rods, by lifting it up and down, you can decrease or increase the temperature. Thus the energy released by the nuclear reaction is given by the equation E is equal to mc square, where E is the energy and m is the mass in kg and c is the velocity of light in meters per second. The notes are given in the description. In the description you will get a link, through that you can download the notes. Thank you for watching.